I've been asked to talk a bit about PSC in pregnancy. So I thought I'd start off by just, well, obviously the most important thing to say is that clearly it's possible to become pregnant. It's possible to have a completely normal pregnancy and to have a normal delivery, even if you have PSC, even if you've had a liver transplant for PSC. And so that's the most important thing to take away from today, I guess. What I thought I'd do is to talk about what sort of the sort of approach that we would take if you were to come to clinic and to say, well, I'm thinking about becoming pregnant, or if you come to clinic and say, oh, I'm pregnant, by the way. Just to talk you through the sorts of things that go through our minds and the sorts of things that we might be asking you to do and the sorts of tests and things that we might be interested in doing if that happens. So I guess the first thing to say is that if you are thinking about being pregnant, we quite like to know about it beforehand, if that's possible. I appreciate that's not always possible, but it makes it easier for us if it's something we can talk about in advance, so we can discuss it with you. We can go through any potential risks to you and to the pregnancy related to your liver disease. So ideally, if somebody comes to me and in clinic and says, well, I'm thinking about becoming pregnant, the first thing that we would like to do is to think about setting up what we call a preconception counselling visit. Okay, so that's not something we would necessarily need to do for everybody, but if there are, if you have complicated medical conditions, sometimes it's something that can be extremely useful. It's a joint clinic visit, usually with one of our obstetric physicians and one of your liver specialists, and that's an appointment we can use to go through in a lot of detail the specific risks associated with you having a pregnancy. So clearly everybody's different and everybody has a slightly different stage of disease, they have a different set of symptoms, and so it's really important to be able to tailor our care to each individual patient. So when we do a preconception counselling visit, the sorts of things that we think about are, so how will the pregnancy affect your liver disease or your liver transplant? And the other question is, what is the effect of your liver disease on the pregnancy? So the first question is relatively easy in that pregnancy in itself probably doesn't have a particularly large effect on PSC in terms of symptoms, in terms of disease progression. Okay, sometimes people with PSC who become pregnant can be more itchy during pregnancy, but that's probably it in terms of symptoms. If you've had a liver transplant for PSC and you become pregnant, again, pregnancy doesn't seem to have a big impact on your liver transplant. So we've looked at data from people that we know from this center who have become pregnant after liver transplantation, and it doesn't seem to be a big risk in terms of problems with your liver transplant itself, so there's no increased risk of rejection or any of these other things. So that's the first question. So the second question is, what is the effect of your liver disease on your pregnancy? And that's where it gets a bit more complicated. So one of the important things for us as clinicians to decide is how advanced we think your liver disease is. And James has already talked a bit about that. If you have significant scarring, so if you have cirrhosis in your liver, that makes a pregnancy more risky. Okay. Now, if you have cirrhosis, you're more likely to have portal hypertension. So I'm going to tell you what I mean by that, because that's a technical term that we use a lot. If you have scarring in your liver, it means that the blood doesn't flow through your liver as easily because it's stiff. And that means that the pressure in the veins that take blood to your liver can go up. And one of the important results, one of the important consequences of that pressure in that vein going up is that the flow of blood through other vessels in your body is changed, and it makes you more likely to develop something we call esophageal varices, which are dilated veins in your gullet, in your esophagus. Okay, so if you have cirrhosis and you want to become pregnant, we would want to arrange for you to have a gastroscopy to have a look to see if you have any varices or not. And that's really important, because if you have varices before you become pregnant, they are likely to get bigger whilst you are pregnant. Okay, that's because when you're pregnant, your overall blood volume goes up, and so the risk of having a bleed from your esophageal varices when you're pregnant is high. So if you have cirrhosis, we recommend that you have a gastroscopy before you become pregnant. If you have varices when we do the gastroscopy, then we would usually recommend they're treated. And that usually means with banding, so little elastic bands are put on the varices to get rid of them effectively. Okay? And we would recommend that happens before you become pregnant, because we know that if you have varices when you're pregnant, the risk of them bleeding is high. And if you have a variceal bleed whilst you are pregnant, that's bad news. Okay? If you have a variceal bleed whilst you're pregnant, the medication that we would usually use to save your life is likely to end your baby's life. Okay, so we want to avoid that situation if at all possible. Doing a gastroscopy and looking for varices and treating them before you become pregnant, ideally. Often we may recommend that you then have another endoscopy whilst you are pregnant. And that's because, as I've said, we know that because of the increase in your blood volume whilst you're pregnant, you're at risk of developing varices whilst you're pregnant. So we often may ask you to have another endoscopy a bit later on in your pregnancy. I think that's one of our main concerns when people with liver disease become pregnant. There are a couple of other things that we want to talk about when you're thinking about becoming pregnant. One of them is your medication. Now, clearly, the medication that we give you is hopefully designed to help you and keep you well. And you staying well is one of the most important ways to make sure that you become pregnant and that you have a normal, healthy pregnancy and a normal delivery. So it's really important not to stop any of your medication without talking to us about it. I know there are some women that have concerns about taking medication during pregnancy, and that's something that we would be very willing to talk with you about. Actually, the majority of the medication that we use to treat people with PSC is okay to take in pregnancy. So that includes things like ursodeoxycholic acid, things that people are taking for their inflammatory bowel disease, so azathioprine, azacol, prednisolone. Those medications are not things that we would usually suggest you stop whilst you're pregnant. The problem can come when, if you've had a liver transplant, looking at your immunosuppression. So there are some immunosuppressive drugs that are used that are not recommended in pregnancy. Those are mycophenolate and sirolimus, and those are known to cause malformations in the baby. So it's not recommended that you become pregnant whilst you're taking those. So clearly, if you are taking those and you would like to become pregnant, we need to have a conversation about swapping them to something safer for pregnancy so that allows you to do that. Okay. But ideally, we'd like to do that clearly before you become pregnant, so that we've got then a bit of time to make sure that your liver tests are stable on any new medication. The other thing about medication I was going to mention was some of you may also be taking beta blockers. We often prescribe those if you have varices. We often prescribe a beta blocker to reduce the risk of bleeding from the varices. And those are also, well, we would usually encourage you to continue taking those during pregnancy. The other thing I think to mention is that we know that a small proportion of people with significant liver disease with cirrhosis related to PSC can have a problem with their lungs, with pulmonary hypertension, it's called. Okay, and so for that reason, for some people, if you're thinking of becoming pregnant, we may want to arrange a scan of your heart just to look at whether that's likely to be a problem or not. Our role as doctors is really to help you manage your liver disease to enable you to live as normal a life as possible and to do the things that you want to do. So if you come to us and say, I'd like to become pregnant, we're unlikely to say, no, you really mustn't do that. Okay. There are a couple of situations where we might say, well, okay, but I think maybe you might be wise to delay. Now might not be a great time. And I think that the occasions where we might say that is if you have advanced liver disease and we're thinking about transplant assessment and transplantation, then probably that's not a very good time to be considering pregnancy. The other time is that immediately after you've had a liver transplant, so we know that if you conceive within 12 months of having a liver transplant, that usually makes your pregnancy more high risk. Otherwise, I think we would like to do all we can to enable you to have a safe and normal pregnancy. And we know that people with PSC are perfectly capable of doing that. There is a small increase in the risk of having a premature baby if you have PSC, okay? And there's also a small increase in your risk of having to have a cesarean section. Both of those things are described as negative outcomes, but actually in current times with modern neonatal medicine, premature delivery isn't necessarily a big deal, and likewise, cesarean sections aren't always a terrible outcome. So often, despite having PSC, you're able to have a good outcome and a healthy baby at the end of it. So PSC is, so James mentioned that PSC is an autoimmune disease, so it's not directly inherited. But we know that people, so first-degree relatives of people with PSC are more likely to have an autoimmune disease. So you inherit some genes that make you more likely to get to have an autoimmune disease, any autoimmune disease, not necessarily PSC. So yes, if you look at all the first-degree relatives of people with PSC, they are slightly more likely to have PSC or another autoimmune disease, but it's not directly inherited, no. So usually we would recommend you have a gastroscopy before you become pregnant. Yeah. If you have varices then, we would want to treat them then. If you don't have varices before you become pregnant, we know there's still a risk that you might develop them during your pregnancy, so we may then want to do another gastroscopy while you're pregnant to have a look and see if you have varices. And if we find them whilst you're pregnant, we can still band them and treat them in the normal way.